Now, we want to revisit that question of information flow. And remember, recall that information flow is a problem that cannot be addressed by discretionary access control. Okay? So we want to see how mandatory access control, or MAC, or multi-level security, in particular the BLP model that we are focusing on. And so how does the BLP model help us solve that information flow problem that we had? So we say we have an object. This is a top secret object. So we have a top secret object 2 is TS. Okay, this is more sensitive information. We never want this information to go and end up in an object that has, you know, level is only secret. Okay, so this is more sensitive. Object 2 is more sensitive than object 1 because we said TS is greater than S. So this is highly top secret information. We never want it to end up in an object that is only classified at the secret level. Okay, so how can this information flow from here to there? Okay, so there are two paths. Path one is that a top secret user reads it. We know that the read down rule means what? For this to read, for someone to be able to read this, the user has to be TS. Okay, otherwise they can't read it. A secret user can only read secret or below. So a top secret user can read this object. Okay, so this read will be allowed. And then they can, this information that they have pulled, remember the Alice, Bob, Charlie example in discretionary access control we had, where Alice gave read access to Bob, who copied the data into a file that he created and then passed it on to Charlie. Well, can user one do something like that? Can it create object two in which it may be able to write this information that it just read from object one? For someone who's not top secret, to be able to read this information, the object we create has to be secret, isn't it? Or lower. Because if a TS, then it's just like here. They won't be able to read object 2. They won't be able to read object 1. So if the object is at a lower level, then the write rule says what? You can only write up. You can't write down. So although a top secret user can take this information, read it, but they're not able to write it in an object that can be read by somebody who is not cleared a top secret. So this path doesn't allow information flow to get to a lower level. What about a secret user? We know the secret user can, once it's here, can read that. I guess we know that a secret user can't read. So this path, we said, is not possible. This path actually ends right here because the secret user is not able to read a top secret document. Okay, because this label would not dominate the label of the object. Okay, so this path, you know, is broken here. This path is broken right here. So this information actually never flows in here. Can information from object one flow into object two? Secret can read this object and can write up yes. But that doesn't violate any confidentiality requirement, isn't it? So secret information can now be read by a top secret person because this information made its way from here through user 2 into this object. A top secret user could already read this, isn't it? Read down. So this direction information flow doesn't make more sensitive information available to a user who is cleared at a lower level. The system would not allow information that is read from this object to be written into an object that is at a lower level. That's a guarantee that comes with BLP and the MAC model that we didn't have with DAC before. So this is how we're able to control information flow, and that's how we fix one of the shortcomings that we had with discretionary access control.